Welcome back to Game Corner.
We're fine. This lady who has 2013 Josh haircut.
Kind of.
I did have a bowl cut unintentionally.
Was it a proper bowl cut?
Wasn't a proper bowl cut. When you look back at it, it is bowl shaped.
It wasn't
like it's
like
Will Byers bowl shaped.
I was going to make that comparison. Yeah. I don't think it was completely Will Byers bowl shaped.
No. But it had that. It was longer at the back.
What did Noah Schnapp do to the fucking Duffer Brothers for them to go, yeah, you have to keep this haircut? They must hate him. He always talks about, yeah, I hope I have a better haircut this season, which I think he kind of did to an extent, but it wasn't completely in the right direction this time around. It was still a bowl. It was just a smaller bowl.
Does the Byers family keep the same haircut all four seasons? Because Jonathan's haircut just the same.
Yeah.
He doesn't really have a haircut. He just has hair.
He has a overgrown bowl, I would say.
Yeah, actually, that's a good point.
So, it's just, they're all about them bowls in the Byers family.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, I look at pictures of me from, like, 2013, and I'm like, that's a bowl cut.
Yeah.
Why did I think that was okay?
It's fine.
I was 15.
It's fine.
I had curtains. Yeah. Very greasy curtains. Yeah, it wasn't a good look.
It's fine. I mean, I didn't really.
I was
like,
a teenager. I don't give a shit.
I didn't really work out what sort of hairstyle I wanted to have until I was like probably 15.
It took me until I was like 18, 19. That's when I started doing the side parting.
Yeah.
The nice wavy side parting. Mm. I like it.
I like it too.
This is it. This is just me forever now. Do you ever have that moment, like, in the mirror? Every so often, I'll be, like, brushing my teeth or something. I'll catch myself in the mirror and be like, fuck, I'm going to look like this for the rest of my life.
Yeah, no, I get... I have that exactly.
We've come out the other side of puberty. This is it. It doesn't change. Unless we get some kind of plastic surgery, that's it.
Yeah, plastic surgery or, like, you know, male pattern baldness. All of that.
Yeah, good
fun
luck with
stuff.
That. I don't have that.
Well, yeah, I mean... So
there's no history of that in my family either side.
There's like, I guess there kind of is, to an extent. So you're supposed to look at
your mother's
yeah, men on your mother's side.
Yeah,
is a pretty good indication for men to have a look at.
Which is fine because you saw my granddad and he still had hair. It was just thin.
Yeah.
I'll just thin. It'll be fine.
So my uncle, he is in his 40s now. He's like, he's a lot younger than my mom and my dad, but I can kind of see where my hair's going to go.
Yeah.
And if it's going to go in that direction, I'm going to be a silver fox, bro. I'm looking forward to it.
You're already a silver fox, just not silver. You're
just a
fox.
Exactly. I'm just a fox. Thanks, man. I appreciate that. I often get compared to... I look like a mixture of my dad and my uncle.
Yeah, well, having met your dad finally a couple of years ago...
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, fuck, they're the same person.
A little bit, yeah.
It was your dad... The fact that I never met your dad before in my life, and we were crashing at his house for con.
Yeah.
He just walked in one day and was like, oh, hey, lads, got to be here. Because you told us that the Sky Man was
going to
come.
Yeah, the Sky Man was going to come and sort stuff
He's
out.
He's like, oh, my dad's going to have to pop in for a bit. And he walked in and I was like, it's Owen, 20 years in the future.
Yeah. It's not even
20. Not even 20.
It's a bit more than 20. I think dad was 25 when he... Oh, my God, that's like basically my age now.
Oh, I'm the same age as my mum when I was born.
Bruh.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, scary.
Yeah, that... Yeah, waking up on my birthday with that realization was not fun.
Oh.
Yeah.
Good.
Well,
I'm
I mean,
glad.
I've also, I like, are we going to get real again on Game Corner?
Sure, go on.
Because I've always had, like, a part of my mental illness.
Yes.
like an inadequacy thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because my parents met each other at secondary school.
Yeah.
Started dating while they were at school, left school, got married, had a kid. And my mum was 24 when she had me.
Which is, like, cool, but I feel like that meant that made sense for people in...
It was the late 90s.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It made sense for people who were born in, like, the 70s/80s to make that sort of decision.
Yeah.
Whereas I think a lot of people our age are generally waiting until they're a bit older to have kids.
Yeah, which is just the way that it goes. Mm. Like, that's
it
how...
It fluctuates.
Yeah, that's how birth rates fluctuate. They just do that. But yeah, so it's been my entire life up until therapy. was just like, oh man, better do this. I'm like, ah.
Oh yeah, you set your expectations of what you're going to do based off of the people around you,
based off of your parents and stuff. Because I've got quite a healthy family dynamic.
Mm.
It's like, oh, this is the standards. Like my morals and shit are based off the stuff that my parents taught me.
Yeah.
Which isn't the same for everybody because some people had shit parents. But like, whatever. So yeah, for a very long time, and occasionally, sometimes even now, before I like catch myself doing it, I'm like, "Wow, I'm really slacking at this whole life thing," and I'm like, "Not really."
Yeah, no, I have to like slap myself out of it and just go, "No, it's an arbitrary comparison that you're making here."
Yeah,
it doesn't really matter. Just
sometimes I'm just like, "Wow, my parents were married by this age," and I'm like, "Yeah, that was 94
and like I'm sure that's probably different for you than it is to me, because I go, oh, my parents were married at this age and that ended up well for them.
So we got to there's like two different schools of thought.
So I'm like, okay, cool, I'll do something different then.
I'm not too worried about it at the moment, but it's definitely when I was a teenager,
things were
harder anyway. Oh, it's just like, oh, I gotta do this before this age, and I'm like,
No,
I don't have to do shit.
Take it at your own pace.
I could never get married. Fuck you, nature.
yeah, for sure.
Societal norms.
Yeah, it's less nature and more societal norms.
Yeah, it is, yeah, yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah, it's just super weird when I think about shit like that. Like, oh yes, 24 years ago was when I was born and my mother was also 24. Huh.
Yeah.
What a way. But then you got to look at all the factors surrounding that as well. It was the late 90s. My parents like each other. My grandparents were already old. My parents were like, if we're going to have kids, then we want to have them like now. So that they'll remember my grandparents. Surprise, surprise, I did. Given that it took 23 years for them to actually die. Which is a fucking achievement.
Bruh, all of mine are still going. You know, touch wood. But like, yeah. I think they were quite young having kids. My parents were quite young having kids.
Yeah.
So we've had the blessing of being able to have them around for a long time.
Yeah. So. I mean, my...
And I've got three sets. That's fucking greedy, man.
Yeah, you do. What a dick.
I blame my parents.
what was I going to say? Yeah, because my mum's parents, those sets of grandparents, had my mum quite late.
Right.
Like, my nan was like 40-something.
Oh, bruh. That's impressive.
Yeah. So, put it in perspective, my granddad was 70 when I was born.
Whoa.
Yeah. Cause he turned 80 when I was 10.
Which is mad, because, like, I can remember my granddad. I remember going to my granddad's 70th birthday.
Yeah.
My
grandparents were born in like the 20s and 30s. Mm. Which was neat. So it was just like, so the year that I was born, my granddad, who was my oldest, closest oldest relative, was 70. And it was like, oh yeah, okay, we're going to have kids now. Because realistically, they'll only manage like, ooh, maybe 7 or 8 years.
Yeah.
Flash forward 23. He's 93. It's just like, I've had enough.
I'm done now.
Let me go.
Please.
Oh, God, love him.
By the way, we're defeating Cyrus right now.
Oh, shit, we are.
Yeah.
Sorry, I just talked to my granddad and I got distracted.
It's okay.
Did you just vault switch?
Yeah, I've just vault switched. I think we've just finished with Cyrus's flying Pokemon, so we can deal with that.
Neat.
So I'm going to go into Frick Your Mom.
Frick Your Mom.
We were going to get a Switch out anyway, but...
I kind of want to get that bit from our old Wind Waker playthrough when my granddad comes in and just save that for something. I don't know. It's just funny.
Oh, yeah. Go for it.
Yeah. Did we ever tell that story on SAS? I can't remember.
I don't know. Maybe.
Maybe. There's back in the way back in the dawn of time.
So before Sassroid was a thing, I mean, we were known as Game Corner, which is what the show is now called. But before Game Corner was even put together,
yeah,
we had like several different goes at formats that we like this sort
We've
of.
We've always been doing this kind of stuff, but never this successfully.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. No, I wouldn't say consistently. I would say
consistently. I was going with like the setups successful. And
yeah, yeah, yeah.
We do like
true.
We do more than we did.
But we did this sort of thing back in like 2013, right?
Yeah, we started doing like Zelda Month when
yeah.
it was just the Owen Cheds channel.
Yeah, and it would be me and you sat down, usually in your lounge with
in
the
like July
with the snowball July with a fan on.
Yeah.
In
your laptop that could have feasibly set the carpet on fire.
Yeah, exactly. Laptop, old capture cards. It was a janky as fuck setup, but
it was so fucking janky.
It's what we could afford at the time.
Yeah.
So it worked.
I think 2013 was the year that we did Wind Waker. And yes. We'd always get like maybe 2 hours into the game and then that was it. And like you wouldn't edit it, so like half of it came out in like August.
Yes.
That was the one year. The year we were doing Wind Waker was my, because I used to live with my grandparents,
mm-hmm.
and they were going out, so they came in to tell me they were going out. It was just me and Owen sat on the sofa, and my granddad just goes, "When are you going to bring any girls home?"
It was the funniest shit ever. I don't even know whether it came up on the recording.
It did. It's actually on the recording because it was a snowball. It's
yeah.
sensitive as shit. But like, it's actually on there, and I could actually pull the clip. In fact, I might even play that now, like future Josh, find it and
go for it.
Do it. Just because it's just so fucking stupid.
Oh,
I believe we just sat there and piss ourselves. Like a solid minute, and then we go back to Zelda.
Morning, grandson. Morning, Owen.
Morning.
When are you going to get pretty girls, so I can say good morning to them?
Yeah. The only reason why those videos aren't still out and about is because, well, like, first of all, we've refined the setup so much at this point that it's almost like a completely different thing.
Yeah.
And plus, we're different people from when we were 13. Like a 13-year-old and 23, 24-year-olds think completely differently.
Yeah.
Like, the biggest things that we had going on in that time were, like, school drama and stuff.
Yeah.
It's like, that's not interesting.
It's not even that we were doing like crazy shit that's not acceptable anymore. It's just not funny anymore.
No, like, I mean, I look back at it, it's like, we were good kids, but like, yeah it's just not.
It's not like we're sitting there doing slurs and
no, yeah, exactly.
Whatever.
Like,
it's,
never.
It's just boring. We didn't have anything to talk about. Like,
yeah.
We'd record and I'd have seen you like for the last 4 days.
In a row, yeah.
And we'd have been talking every day.
Well, think about it. We struggle at the moment trying to make sure that we got fresh stuff that we can talk about on a regular basis.
And we see each other like once a week tops.
Yeah, exactly. And like, we're struggling. We're like, oh my God, we've already spoken about a load of stuff.
Well, we started doing the Solok and we were just like, shit, we have to record Pokemon.
Yeah. And that's like another thing on top of it.
Yeah.
It's fine. Just means that the next Solok stream is going to be pretty boring. But it's fine. I've got a lot of game knowledge stuff to throw down in the next session.
We usually find something to yell about anyway. Also, Solok is so much of us just going, please don't die.
Yeah, please.
Because also it being randomized adds another layer of interesting stuff to talk about.
Yeah. There we go. Saturn's down.
Oh, sick. Do we get the red chain? We get the red chain from Saturn, don't we?
I think so. And then we press the button to let him go.
Or do we get the red chain from pressing the button?
We press the button. Don't know why Saturn's still here. Fucking leave, bro.
And they left.
Saturn fucking teleports too.
Oh, he did. He just disappeared. Bing. Oh my God.
Love that guy.
Yeah.
He's my favorite of all of the planets. Not really.
No.
I'm actually a big Pluto fan, even though Pluto...
You're a big Pluto stan?
Yeah. Constantly it gets
shafted.
Yeah, it just gets on what's the word? Recategorized.
Categorized, yeah.
Like, come on, man. I'm here for Pluto justice. I'm sure that's a thing, right?
I've never thought about what planet I like. I don't know. I'm a big... I like Jupiter. I like Mars.
Mm.
I mean, everyone likes Uranus.
Exactly. That's what I always hear. Boy, I love Uranus. I'm like,
hate to see me go, but love to watch me walk away.
Yeah. Right, we're about to scale Mount Coronet.
Nice, nice.
Which means we're like getting very close to the end of the game.
We are. Count Coronet, Sunny Shore, Elite Four.
Yep. That's it. In a bubble. So, town map, best place to go in from is Celestic, and then go down.
Yeah. Good idea.
Or you can go up. Hmm.
Yeah, but I think you're supposed to go in from the top entrance.
We'll see.
Either Eterna or Celestic.
Yeah, let's see what it gives us.
Route 211.
Bag? Give me super potion. Right. Just bash through this real quick. Yep. We'll soon find out. So we need to go down, hit... Oh, for sure.
An escape rope?
Not on my watch.
Oh, you know?
I think we have gone the wrong way. Because we'd need to push that down. Okay, so...
Do we have strength?
Yeah, we do.
Okay, good. I have not been paying attention.
So let's.
I'm glad you are.
That,
I'm glad you're paying attention, viewer, because I don't know what the fuck is going on. I zoned out for so much of today.
So actually, I'm going to go.
I looked up and two gyms were beat.
Hmm? I looked up and two gyms were beat?
Yeah, pretty much.
Bruh. So you like. We've been doing like a gym an episode, so you blanked out for two episodes.
That's only like 40 minutes. That's. Yeah. Oh, no, that's quite a lot.
that's only like half the recording session. Whee!
Oh, God.
Cool. Yeah. So, why am I
still
on my
bike?
Oh, yeah,
you
got
to go across the water.
Oh, I remember having like a massive problem with this last time I did it. Because like the controls on this game are really fucking jank. And I kept on going over this ledge.
Yeah, you kept jumping off there.
So,
off the arm
and now, there we go. Fucking hell! What the fuck?
Like, okay, we're going to be real careful, and then repeats his own mistake.
Well, the thing is I was like, oh, I'll be smart this time. I'll use the D-pad. The D-pad didn't help. It actually made it much worse.
Okay. One more. Okay. Okay, there we go.
Got it.
Woo. Okay.
For the gigs, I'm just going to come back down and just go like, didn't do it. Cross here. I want you.
What is it? A max potion?
Yeah.
Ooh.
It's kind of helpful.
Thank you, the gods of the mountains.
Yeah, stupid people that leave shit everywhere.
Fucking tourists littering and shit.
Yeah, in a cave.
Ancient
with
cave.
With a box of scraps.
With a box of ancient scraps.
Yes, more repel, please. Ooh,
that was close. I saw that. I was like, oh no.
Don't worry about it. It's fine. Pro gamer.
Pro gamer move.
Up here. And then we start making...
You start fighting grunts. Not that guy, though.
Walking fast. I'm
going... Ooh, how did you do that?
I'm just invincible.
You just fucking finessed
I'm just,
that guy.
I'm simply that good, Joshua. Do you not know this already?
I'm simply that good.
Now that cave's a lie. We need to go this way.
That cave is a lie. Oh dear.
Oh
yeah, this is like one of the three places in the game you can use water for.
Yeah, and I think it's you get I might be thinking platinum. You get a an item specifically for one of the legendary Pokemon. It might be both. It might be both the Lustrous and
Gris. No,
it's not the Grisius because
that's Giratina.
Giratina.
Adamant. Yeah. Because I had to go through what the fucking people in Legends were called because they're named after the orbs.
Adamant.
Yeah.
Got him. Zoom zoom. Zoom zoom.
Yes, please. Thank you very much.
Right. Okay. So you're still here. Come on. I'm going to send in Snoop Lion.
Snoop Lion.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. So I did a fucking sneaky. Oh, I'll tell this very quickly, and then we end the episode.
Okay.
I didn't. Well, it's kind of a sneaky. For one of the newest episodes, as of time of recording.
Yeah.
I made the thumbnail. It's the one where we did the trade, and I made the thumbnail Dialga.
Yeah. I looked at that and I went, when the fuck did we get a Dialga?
Yeah, I got Adam with it because he was telling me about it on Tuesday. He looked at it and he went, wow, they made real good progress. They made it to the legendary already. And I went, Adam, you know Dialga's the legendary for Diamond, don't you?
Yeah.
It's like, oh, I forgot about that.
You know, I looked at it and I went, that's the wrong game, Josh. I wonder if that's on purpose. And then I went, oh, wait, no, we did the trade for that.
I was like, how many people can I get with this?
the two people that watch. And one of them records it.
Yeah, one of them was there. Anyway, that'll do.
Yeah, that'll do.
Get out of here, you scamps.
We'll see you later.
Bye.
Fuck off.
Oh.
I love you. I'm sorry. Bye.